when she could see that in me, she didn't want to do that to me. Are y'all with me? But I had to show that I was vulnerable, that because I love her, no matter what I did, my idea was not to her. Are y'all with me? It takes that humility to do that. I couldn't do that in myself. Amen? See, many of us are proud like Nebuchadnezzar. He was talking about all the things that he did. I have built this city. I have built the great Babylon. God lowered him real quickly. God allowed the circumstances, but yet still, Nebuchadnezzar had to humble himself. Okay? Show me a thankful person, you will see humility. And the awareness that every good and perfect gift comes down from the Father in heaven, and he praised God in a loud voice. Hallelujah. So you gotta learn to sing your lungs out for Jesus. Amen. Amen? Amen? Praise God. I was happy to see him say he was happily married for 52 years. Amen. When you see my dad talk about he's been happily married for 49 years. Amen? Amen. When you see Brother Darrell talk about he's happily married for 30 plus years. Amen? Amen. You want that. Amen? Fourthly, when God grants you an answer to a fervent prayer, be just as fervent in your response to it. Amen? Luke 17, 12 and 13 says, as he was going into the village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, Jesus, Master, have pity on us. First they called and they elevated their voices continually. It wasn't one cry. That word in the Greek speaks of him continually saying, Master, Master, have mercy on us. They weren't, Master, please help me. They were desperate. When they said, have pity, they mean help us, give us aid to us. We are afflicted. Even more so, often in times of bitter need, we pray with intensity. And then when the answer comes, and we go on soon forgetting what God has done for us. After we've done all the crying, we got to show the same exuberance of praising him and thanking him for what he's done. And let me tell you something. One of the ways we do it, we go out and hurt and help those that were hurting much like we were. That's why I was touched when Brother Chris was talking about, said, Pastor, we had a moment after we finished everything. We were in the back and he says, Pastor, you know, this is touching me on a real way. And I could see in his eyes it was deeper than he was like, I used to be one of those kids with the parents in a shelter needing aid. And now I can give the aid. Are y'all with me? So I've come full circle. And God's blessed you so that you can be a blessing. He's raised you up so that you can be a blessing. It's not all for yourself, but for you to help someone else. You got to know that. Amen? Lastly, but not least. Ask the Lord to make us sensitive and open our eyes to what he's doing in our lives, the gifts he has given us, and how he's blessed us. Psalms 103 is a good example of this. You want to turn to that? You want to highlight this? The last scripture I'm giving you. It's my last slide, I believe. Ask the Lord to make us sensitive and open our eyes. Let's just do that right now. Lord, make us sensitive. Open our eyes. Help us to see you in a fresh and in a real way, God. Help us not to take our situation for granted, God. God, help us to see you. In Jesus' name. Amen. It doesn't take a whole bunch. Just asking him to show you. Amen. Psalms 103, 2 and 5 says, Bless the Lord, O my soul. Some of us know this part. And forgive now all of thy business. All, not some, all. Who forgives us all. Some of your iniquity? All your iniquity, all your evil. You can say, Lord, forgive me, and he does. Now that's love. That's love, you know, because some of us will forgive, but we won't forget. But he forgives, remembers, and still forgets. Now you figure it out. Are you with me? He doesn't forget a thing because he's all wisdom, but he forgets it. He doesn't hold it against us. You know, some of us will be like, you know, yeah, I love that person, but you know what? They serve time for stealing stuff, so don't let them be in the house along with our stuff. How many know what I'm talking about? Yeah, praise the Lord, hallelujah, I know you're saved, but watch him, he's going to the room by himself. We had some family members growing up, we couldn't leave them in the room by themselves. Because they just happen to be just pick up stuff. Finding stuff in your house. Finding $100 bills. How you get in my dad's safe? I just found it. But that'd be a watch it. Go into the room. But you know what? When God forgives, he forgets all about it. He gives you a chance after chance after chance because he loves you. And he wins you over with his love. Amen? The Bible says by loving kindness, he draws us. One day I'll do a message called The Power of Love. The Power of Love. Who forgives us all our iniquity, who heals all our diseases, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with steadfast love and mercy, who satisfies you with good so that your youth is renewed like eagles. You know what? This lets me know if I keep an attitude of gratitude, my life will be renewed like an eagle. Yeah, it's Thanksgiving time. It's time to give thanks as a nation for our blessing. As George Washington said, as Abraham Lincoln said, but beyond Thanksgiving, beyond the shopping, beyond all the things that we've made it to be, it's time to give thanks back to God. And I want to challenge every person as we end, as we wrap this up, I want to challenge you to keep a thankful heart. As you sit with your family and you pray with your family over your meal, be thankful. Don't let grace be something that you just say just to get it out of the way. Realize that you actually could be on the street. Are you with me? As you get in your cars and you start up your car, and it may not be the vehicle that you want or your dream vehicle, just be thankful for what you have. As you turn the key to your apartment or your house or your whatever, your trailer, be thankful. Amen? Because it could be worse. Are you with me? Keep the vision in sight for something greater, but be thankful for what you have. Are you with me? You know, as you walk, you may not have the sneakers that you want or the shoes that you want, young people. But be thankful for what you have, because there's some people that don't even have shoes. You know, many of you have went out with us under the bridges, and we give the second-hand and the third-hand shoes that we've saved that are in good condition. And, you know, I saw one, I'll never forget what got me, when this guy, 6'2", we had size 13s, and we gave him these shoes. And he came there, he was frowning, he was mad. And when we gave him the shoes, he walked with us. For smile, and those secondhand shoes made his day. What you would have looked at and said, man, that's not good enough for me. It was the best thing for him. Never forget when I went to Puerto Rico and I went to the mission field and we were there at an orphanage and we gave. And I always have to illustrate this because I do a camp every year and we give Pop-Tarts. And everybody's like, I want this flavor. I don't eat this. I don't eat that. We gave them Pop-Tarts. They didn't care what flavor it was. Chocolate, strawberry. They weren't chocolate. They didn't care. Plain. They were just happy. A couple kids started crying because we gave them a Pop-Tart. Many of them, their parents were in jail. The mom, the dad were in jail. And they didn't have any loved ones to care after them. And y'all, they cried over a Pop-Tart. They were thankful. One of the kids says, now I know God loves me and he's real because he sent you to bring me a Pop-Tart. I'm not making that up. That's real. So many things we take for granted. But all God wants us to do is to be thankful. Stand to your feet, everybody. And I'm coming down.